The Gambia government was among the founding members and signatories of the African Risk Capacity Establishment Agreement in November 2012 and has since played an active role in driving the ARC's work forward. Located at the center of development and adaptation efforts, capacity risk assessment has become even more critical with the 2019-2020 agricultural season characterized by late rains, which were followed by sporadic and uneven distribution of rainfall that led to occasional flash floods and intermittent dry spells. The shifting pattern has affected nearly 351,000 people in the Gambia amid an emergency, which demands closer attention to understand and resolve the needs of farmers to make communities more resilient. Officials say capacity risk needs for a targeted 398,000 people, which was not reached this year, resulting in the non-triggering of Gambia's payout. Speaking at the validation workshop convened to tackle a growing emergency, the National Coordinator of the African Risk Capacity, Maudu Ahmed Jallo, said government is going into premium insurance financing as a risk reduction measure to protect the livelihoods of local farmers.
Government is hard put in itself to finance premium, requiring it to seek for external support, which means that the small monies that are going to be spent on premium should be maximized optimally, so that you know the impact that it is supposed to deposit, once it has deposited, you know, it can be sustained in a way that can be very useful for the people that we serve, and that's the farmers. As a government, of course, we are committed to protecting the livelihoods of the people, and that is why we are going in for a premium financing as a risk reduction measure.
Bernard Uzima, head of technical support division of the Africa Risk Capacity based in Johannesburg, says most of Africa's food shortages are caused by drought.
We want to undertake a review of how the season in the Gambia in 2019 performed. We would want to consider if there are any changes to be made to the choice of parameters that we use for risk modeling, and then evaluate the impact of those changes on the risk profile. The reason why we do this is to ensure that the risk profile that we eventually have for the Gambia correctly depicts the events that happened on the ground, the drought events, such that the country's participation in the risk pool is based on very concrete and robust data and information.
The African Risk Capacities polling on the African continent continues to forecast droughts in African countries and a related component in being done for the Gambia. The insurance scheme triggers payouts for African countries affected by drought, causing crop failure, economic loss, as well as environmental and land degradation. Changing weather patterns brought rainstorms and flash floods that caused havoc in rural Gambia, where farmers are facing the effects of reduced productivity. Reporting for GRTS News, I'm BAI Ibrahim Cham.